Now we discussed this joint for shear failure, if you remember. Again, we are going to discuss this case, but this time we are going to talk about its tensile strength, tensile failure of this type of joint. Since both the plates have same setup, have same arrangement of rivets, so we are just going to focus on any one. So you look here. This is, let's say, section AA. This is section BB. As I've already told you, it's very important in tensile failure to determine which section we are going to decide for tensile strength, because each section may have different tensile strength, may have different failure in case of tension. Because if you look at section AA, it has three rivet holes, so it is going to look like this. This area needs to get filled for three rivets in the same width. But when it has only two rivets, I'm just removing one rivet, okay. When it has only two rivets, then the area which is needed to be filled will increase. So each section, if they have different number of rivets, will have different tensile strength, right? So as I've already told you, it's important for you to decide the section first in case of tensile failure. Now here you see, section AA has lesser area which is to be failed with tension as compared to the area, cross-sectional area of the plate in section BB. So if you look at tensile strength, you need to write PT is equal to sigma T multiplied by area which is to be failed from tensile failure. In case of AA, that area is more. So tensile stress which will be coming out, in case of section AA, the area which needed to be failed through tension is less. So tensile strength of the plate along section AA will be less than its tensile strength along section BB. So which one will you pick? Now what you will say that, sir, from the point of view of design, you have told that always consider the lesser value of strength, always underestimate the strength of the component. So since the tensile strength of the plate will be less along AA, so we are going to consider the area of the plate along the section AA. This will be your answer, but this is incorrect answer. Why? Let's have a look. It's a very interesting case which can be asked to you in GATE. If you look at the failure along AA, definitely AA will fail first, because area of BB section, area of plate in BB is more as compared to area of plate in AA. So as you will keep on applying the load, let's say you started the applying load gradually from 0 up to the value of P, so obviously lesser value will be reached first. Since section AA will fail at lesser value of P, so AA will fail. This plate here will get fractured like this here as a result of tensile failure. But has the joint failed? This is also a condition. Plate has definitely failed, but has the joint failed? We are talking about the failure of the joint. Joint has not failed. How? Look at this diagram here. In this diagram, you can see that this is still holding up. These two rivets are still holding this plate. This is the plate. And these two rivets are still holding it. It is different than shear failure. In shear failure, all of them needed to be sheared in order to make sure that the plate fails, right? In this case, even if these means the plate has failed in this section, some of you can think that total plate has failed. Now the joint has failed. But if you practically imagine the situation, joint has not failed. Although the plate has cracked from this region, but these rivets here along section BB and the plate along section BB is still intact. It is not broken. So ultimately, plate 1 and 2 are still in contact with each other, are still joined together. But when section BB is going to fail, section BB of plate is going to fail, then what will happen? Basically, this section fails of the plate, then this region of the plate, it will move to the left. Earlier, when plate was getting fractured from A, still it was not going out, still it was not moving away from the other plate because it was connected at the section BB. But when this section of the plate is going to fail, then this part will move away, right? Irrespective of whether it failed at AA or not. Suppose at AA there was only single rivet. If there was only single rivet, the area of the plate which was needed to be shared will be even more. So AA will not fail, BB will fail first, right? If the AA has only one rivet, it has more area of the plate, right? There will be only one rivet, let's say. So more area of plate means AA will fail even at higher value of load than BB, where there are two rivets. But there you have to again consider the section BB only. The strength of section AA is not going to matter. Whether plate is broken or intact at section AA, it does not matter, because even if this is intact, if this fails, the plate will move away. So what you need to remember is that for tensile failure of riveted joints, when you have a setup where more than one rows are present, then the strength, tensile strength, will be decided by that row which is nearest to this edge. You see, if you consider this edge, this is near, this is far. So strength will be decided by that row which is nearest to the edge. And always try to visualize these cases. If any such question is asked, always try to draw a diagram. Calm yourself, think about it. When this part is going to move out, then you will say that joint has broken. Even if this part is still here, but the plate has broken, a small part is left, but plate has gone, joint has been broken. That is practical, right? So always consider failure along section BB, along this section, irrespective of what is the strength of AA, whether AA has failed or AA is still there. Okay, so how much will be the area that you need to consider? The strength, the tensile strength of this joint is equal to tensile strength of section BB is equal to sigma t multiplied by area of the plate along section BB. And area of the plate along section BB is its width W. Let's say this is having a width W, minus, there are two rivets, so minus 2d multiplied by this thickness. This is the thickness of the plate t. D here, again I am telling you, is the diameter of rivet hole and not the diameter of rivet, because here we are talking about the failure of plate. So the features of plate will be considered. Diameter of rivet hole, which is in the hole size in the plate, that will be considered. Okay,